For over 1,000 generations, the Jedi Knights were the most powerful, most respected force in the galaxy. In the ages before the rise of the Emperor Palpatine, before the fall of Darth Vader, before the birth of Luke Skywalker, the Jedi Knights were the guardians of peace and justice in the Old Republic. Through all the long years, their stories have been preserved. Two of the most famous of these Jedi warriors were Ulic Keldroma and Nomi Sunrider, young Jedi Knights of great power who learned to master the ways of the Force. Their adventures were a prelude to the great wars that would follow, for the rise and fall of empires, and for all future clashes between the dark side and the light. The battle that would alter the course of the galaxy begins on the planet Arcania, where the great Jedi Master Arca patiently trains his three apprentices, the brash young Ulic Keldroma, his brother Kay, and the alien called Tot Donita, a member of the Twi'lek race. Listen now to these stories of good and evil, these legends of heroes and villains struggling for control of the galaxy, these Tales of the Jedi.
Ulic.
Thanks, Kay.
By the goddess of the Twi'leks, your brother handles his lightsaber well, Kay.
He's the best, Tot Donita.
Whoa!
Still, are you sure you wouldn't like some help, my friend?
Oh, you know better than to ask that, Tot Donita. I can handle this on my own. This training droid is old and slow.
Then maybe we should turn it up a notch. With your permission, Master Arca.
Yes, Kay. I think your older brother could use a more difficult test.
All right, Ulic. The Jedi Master has spoken. A better test for our great hero. I'll just open up this droid's energy regulators and... off you go!
That's better! But still, good enough, to beat me! There!
Hooray!
Well done, Ulic.
Thank you.
But I believe you should.
Ow!
Watch your back, my young pupil.
Ulic, you should have known that droid was still armed. Are you all right?
Sure, Kay. Just a bruised ego is all.
Your brother lets his courage cloud his mind, Kay.
Tot Donita speaks well, Ulic. A Jedi needs more than mere bravery. Overconfidence has been the undoing of many a seasoned warrior. Let the Force be your strength.
You're right, as usual, Master Arca. If that training droid had been using deadly force, I'd be a burn mark on the wall right now.
Well, you still did a pretty good job on it. I'd better get to work fixing it back up.
Sit down, Kay. The droid can wait. I have a story to tell all three of you. But you must listen as a Jedi listens.
Kay, pay attention. It's disrespectful to fix your lightsaber when a Jedi Master is talking to you.
I'm not fixing it, Ulic. I'm tuning the blade.
Shh!
Open your thoughts to me. Let my words become images in your minds. Listen to me, Ulic. Listen to me, Kay. Listen to me, Tot Donita. Through the Force, you will see things, other places, the future, the past. Light years from here, orbiting a yellow sun, is the world of Onderon, circled by its four moons.
I see it. It's a terrible place. Desolate.
I see it too. Creatures live there. Monsters with wings. Big as skyhoppers.
With terrible jaws.
I too see the vision. Is it the future or...
the past. You see the distant past of the planet Onderon. Eons ago, the atmospheres of Onderon and its fourth moon would touch briefly during the summer season. In those days, a number of these savage creatures learned to escape the confines of their lunar home and migrated to the planet Onderon.
But... there are people on that planet. primitive, helpless.
They'll be slaughtered.
What's that?
Creatures coming out of the clouds.
They're coming this way. Look out!
My baby! It's got my baby!
And so it was. The peaceful Onderonians were utterly unprepared for these savage beasts. The winged creatures hunted and ate them at will, grew fat and multiplied. The gentle Onderonians were forced to develop weapons of death. In a few brief years, the Onderonians learned the pleasures of hunting and began to kill the monsters for meat and sport.
Master, my people, the Twi'lek race of the planet Ryloth, say that war is the beginning of civilization.
Well, Tart, on the planet Onderon that was certainly the case. Behold the vision as the eons pass.
I see the tribes pass away. Civilization begins. Tribal culture evolved into true civilization.
But Master Arca, the vision is strange. I see only one gigantic city on the whole planet.
There is only one city on Onderon. Thanks to the constant threat of the beasts, Onderonian society developed into one great walled fortress called Iziz.
In the vision, it grows year by year.
I've never seen a city so huge. There must be millions of inhabitants.
Watch out! The beasts are attacking!
Stay calm, Kay. It is only a vision. Year after year, the winged beasts attacked the city, drawn by the scent of Onderonian flesh. But the people developed more powerful weapons and drove the creatures back. Inside the city, civilization ruled. But beyond its walls, most of the planet remained a savage outland roamed by the vicious beasts.
For crimes against the city, I exile you to the wilderness beyond the walls.
No! No!
During the ages, it became the Onderonians' custom to exile lawbreakers into the wilderness.
Out you go, lawbreaker!
No! Have mercy! No!
At first, the monsters provided quick and efficient execution for these outcasts. But eventually, the outlaws learned to tame the flying beasts.
Lash it down!
Get that rope secure!
Watch out for those jaws! Get that muzzle on!
A few of the outcasts established themselves as powerful warlords, with great armies of vicious beasts at their command. Onderon became a divided world. A world constantly at war, as both the outlaws and the city dwellers developed more and more powerful weapons of destruction.
The vision, it's fading.
We have reached the present. Now the people of Onderon have asked the Republic to intercede, and the Republic, in turn, has called upon the Jedi for help. I have agreed to become the watchman of the Onderon system.
Are you going to leave us, Master Arca? Or will you take us with you?
I'm not taking you with me, Ulic, because I'm staying here. You are going to Onderon.
What?
Us? I don't understand.
Don't you see, Kay? At last, after all our years of training, we've been given our first mission. Tot Danita and my brother Kay are already aboard the Nebulan Ranger, Master Arca. I just wanted to thank you again. We won't fail you.
The Onderonians have asked for help in ending their centuries-long state of war. They will want you to fight, but remember, Ulic, the Jedi bring peace. Use your weapons as a last resort.
We will do as you ask, Master. We only request that you keep us in your thoughts.
In the power of the Force, I will be with you, Ulic. But this is to be a test of your knighthood. You and your companions must make your own way through the difficulties you will encounter. May the Force be with you.
Ulic, the navigation computer says we're approaching the Onderonian system. We'll hit their gravity well any minute.
Stop fiddling with the instruments, Kay. Relax. Tot Danita was just telling me more about his homeworld.
As I was saying, my people, the Twi'leks, have an ancient and rich history of nonviolence. We prefer intellect and cleverness to outright brutality.
Entering the gravity well of Onderon, Ulic. I'm cutting in sublight engines.
But I've heard that some Twi'leks have begun forming alliances with off-worlders, Tot. Even with smugglers like the Hutts.
Sublight engines engaged. Entering the atmosphere.
All species have their stray members, Ulic. You can't hold the race responsible for the actions of...
Sorry to interrupt your pleasure with business, boys, but I've got a flight of giant birds on a collision trajectory.
All right, angle the deflector shields, Tot. I'm taking the Nebulan Ranger down another 1,000 meters. That should...
No good, Ulic. The whole swarm is maneuvering to hit us.
What kind of crazy birds would...
I've got a visual sighting, Ulic. Those aren't birds. They're beast riders, armed with...
Heavy blasters, beginning evasive maneuvers.
Deflectors are holding. Shall I return fire?
No. Master Arca sent us here to make peace. We'll fly through the swarm without firing a shot. Kay, contact the city.
I'm on it. Attention, city of Aziz. This is the Nebulan Ranger requesting permission to land. Repeat, Nebulan Ranger requesting...
We read you, Nebulan Ranger. You are expected. Turn on course 030 to the Royal Space Dock.
We have a slight problem, Aziz. Actually, we estimate 30 to 40 slight problems. Beast riders using our ship for target practice.
Continue on your present heading, Nebulan Ranger. Our defensive batteries will take care of those beast riders.
That ship is breaking through. It's going to reach the city.
We must stop it. The Jedi must not be allowed to reach Aziz. I'm taking my beast riders after them. Yeah!
Wait, not here. We're too close to the perimeter. Those turbo blasters will... Too late. That's more good men I've lost to the city dwellers. They will pay in blood.
Jedi Knights, welcome. I am Novar, advisor to Queen Amanoa, ruler of Aziz.
Queen Amanoa? We had heard that King Omen ruled the city.
Sadly, the king has recently passed into the darkness. Queen Amanoa rules here in his great name.
I am Ulic Keldroma. This is my brother Kay, and this...
An alien life form! Guards, seize him!
Hey!
What's going on? This is Tot Donita, our companion. Tell your armor-plated turbos to...
We have a strict ban on aliens entering the Royal Citadel. The Royal Protectors will remove this one for interrogation.
Didn't I say it? We are Jedi. Let him go!
Be careful, Jedi. Mortal threats on your part will cause severe political repercussions.
Novar, the Queen orders the three Jedi to the throne room. At once!
The Queen's throne room is just ahead.
This is quite a city, don't you think, Tot?
Indeed, Kay. It covers hundreds of square miles. Millions must live inside its walls. But I find something disturbing.
No, you're just angry about the misunderstanding at the docking bay, Tot. Remember, we're here to bring peace.
Jedi Knights! This is Her Majesty, Queen Amanoa, and her daughter, Princess Galia.
These are the Jedi?
They look more like untutored youths.
Queen Amanoa, I am Ulic Keldroma. These are my companions.
Come, boy. When we asked for help in dealing with these beast riders, we were expecting a great Jedi master, not boys.
Master Arca has entrusted us with the job of bringing peace to this system. Please understand, Queen Amanoa, once you embrace the Republic, the power of all the Jedi is ready to serve you.
A nice speech, little boy, but we shall reserve our judgment. In the meantime, let me introduce my daughter, Princess Galia.
It's an honor to meet such young Jedi.
Oh, I'm getting tired of this.
Jedi, as you know, we are plagued by outlaws. These beast riders are led by a savage named Oran Kira. My poor daughter cannot even go to the forest without 100 armed men. But I believe the threat has become even more serious. The attack on your ship suggests that the outlaws now have spies within the city itself. Somehow they knew of your approach even before we did. What was that? Novar?
View screen on.
Northern Rampart. Heading for the palace. Repeat. Beast Riders have broken through the Northern Rampart. They're heading for the...
Beast Riders!
Guards! Defend us!
By the Twi'lek Goddess. They're the same bunch that swarmed the Ranger.
Here's your chance to prove the power of your promises, Jedi. Will you help us now to defend our city?
Yes. We'd be honored. K-Tot, are you with me?
We're with you, brother.
Let's go.
Come, my daughter. We will flee while the Jedi delay our enemies.
But Mother, I...
Come. My personal bodyguards will defend us.
Jedi pest, my beast will eat you alive.
First you'll have to reattach its head to its neck.
Nice piece of work, Ulick.
These beast riders are no problem. Between us and the palace guards, we've got them licked.
Don't be too rash, Ulick. I saw two beast riders slip through. I'll bet a Hutt's ransom they're after the Queen.
Okay, Tot. You and Kay follow them. I'll keep this bunch busy.
Are you kidding? You can't handle these guys alone.
Don't worry, Tot. Go on. These beast riders are slower than a third-rate training droid.
Hurry, Gobi. You're slower than a third-rate...
I'm running as fast as I can. I'm used to riding on the back of my beast, not hoofing it down hallways in the royal palace.
This will be your first and last trip, Beast Rider.
Well, if it isn't two of the royal bodyguards. And there's the Queen and her lovely daughter.
Mother!
Guards, defend us!
Stand and die, invaders!
Did he say die?
That's what he said!
Now, Queen Aminoa.
Cursed enemies! I call down the power of the ancient Jedi, Freedon Nad, upon thee!
Right. I guess Freedon Nad must be nadding off.
You beast riders have killed her!
Don't worry, Princess. She's only lightly stunned. She'll come around in a few seconds. Now, let's go. You're coming with us.
Come on, Tot. I think they're down here.
Gone. My daughter, gone.
Tot, I found the bodies. The Beast Riders killed the guards and Queen Aminoa.
No, Kay. The Queen is alive.
Cursed Jedi. You said you came to protect us.
Your Majesty, where is your daughter?
Taken. My poor Galia, taken by those savages.
Kay, Tot, I followed as soon as I could. The Beast Riders turned tail and ran. I guess we were too. What happened here?
Ulick Keldrama, is this my reward for asking you to help our beleaguered city? The loss of my daughter? I demand in the name of the Republic that you seek out the kidnappers and bring her back.
You have our word, Your Majesty.
Ulick, can I speak with you? Master Arca put you in charge of this mission, Ulick, but he also says that you're overconfident. I think we should report back to Master Arca. Let him make the decision.
No, it's time for us to prove to Master Arca that we are worthy of being called Jedi Knights.
I don't know, Ulick. I don't trust these people. Something about them.
Queen Aminoa, we leave at once for the wilds of Onderon. We will not return until we have freed your daughter.
Excellent, young Jedi. Excellent.
Oh, man, I hate pulling this kind of duty. I don't know why Auron Kira stuck us out here in the middle of the jungle.
Come on, Gobi. Keep your eyes on your instruments. Auron Kira's the boss, and he says these hunter-seeker torpedoes we're manning are important. Now that we've got hold of the princess, the Queen's sure to send out search parties.
Yeah, sure, but those sensor operators in the city couldn't find their backsides in the bathtub. They'll never find us in all this wilderness.
Yeah? Then what's that?
It's an off-world ship, and it's headed right for Auron Kira's hideout.
Ulic, I've got a power reading dead ahead. Looks like a main generator, big enough to power up a small city.
Visual sighting. There's a small fortress built into the mountainside. I can see a few of those winged beasts circling the tower.
That must be the Beast Rider's hideout, Kay. Tot, cut our speed to half throttle and come around to...
Ulic, I've got a small object in flight, heading our way.
What is it? More Beast Riders with hand blasters?
Negative. It's a secret torpedo doing magnitude 6 over the speed of sound. Tot, hit the shield! Hit the shield!
I think we're alive.
Okay. Are you in one piece?
Sure. One piece. One really bruised piece, but one piece. I can't believe we survived that.
We did, thanks to Tot.
I activated the shields. Too late to stop the torpedo, but the shields absorbed some of the energy of the explosion. Then, as the Ranger went down, I angled the shields to cushion our fall.
Damage report, Kay?
Activating computer now.
Damage assessment. Specify parameters.
Sublight drive.
Working. Damage assessment. Sublight systems. Ion drive 20% operational. Solid fuel retro thrusters 40% operational. Inertial stabilizers inoperative. Lateral fin inoperative. Sublight transponder inoperative.
I guess that means the ship won't go.
That's what it means. I can fix the stabilizers and the lateral fin, but it'll take at least a day.
All right, Kay. Stay here with the ship and see what you can do. Tot and I will investigate that fortress we spotted before we went down.
Are you sure they went down around here, Gomi?
I know how to read my tracking scopes. Those Jedi are around here somewhere. Trouble is, the same jungle that hides us from the city dwellers hides those Jedi from us.
We'll have to keep looking till we...
Till you find us, Beast Rider?
There they are! All right, Jedi, keep your hands away from those lightsabers!
We don't need lightsabers to deal with you.
Huh?
You should put your weapons away.
We should put our weapons away.
And tell us where we are.
You are in the wilds of Onderon, near the stronghold of our leader, Auron Kira.
Good work, Ulic. Your skills of control have grown powerful.
Where is Princess Scalia?
In the fortress. She is going to be married to Auron Kira.
Married?
Ulic, we must stop them.
Take us to Auron Kira.
We gather beneath the four moons of Onderon to perform the ceremony of binding. Who among you bears witness to this great event?
We do! The warriors of Auron Kira!
Aye!
Then you are witnesses to the life vows of these two. Galia, Princess of Onderon.
And Auron of the House of Kira.
You drink of Ulic, cup, give me a hand.
Come on, Tot.
Up you. Go. There. By the Twi'lek goddess. Ulic, there must be 400 Beast Riders down there.
And there's Princess Scalia. Looks like they're forcing her to marry that muscle-bound savage with the long hair.
How are we going to stop the ceremony?
Easy. We ask them nicely.
Princess Scalia, in the name of the four moons of Onderon, take the hand of Auron Kira.
Stop!
Who dares interrupt the binding ceremony?
I do. Ulic Kildroma of the Jedi.
A Jedi Knight? Here! Guards, take him!
I've sworn to rescue Princess Scalia, and nothing will get in my way.
Impressive. But let's see how your Jedi powers help you against me, Auron Kira.
He is not alone, Beast Rider.
Tat Danita stands with him.
Wait!
What?
Why can't you Jedi leave me alone?
Princess Galia, I'm here to rescue you and return you to your mother.
You idiot. I don't want to be rescued. I want to marry Auron Kira.
Eat. Drink. Everyone must celebrate the marriage of Auron Kira, Lord of the Beast Riders.
What's wrong, Kay? Why aren't you eating?
I'm still bewildered, Ulic. You and Tot leave me alone in the jungle to fix the Nebulan Ranger while you go off to rescue Princess Galia. The next thing I know, you come back, tell me the princess has happily married the leader of these Beast Riders, and we're invited to the party. Tot, can you make sense of this?
The first lesson I learned as a Jedi, Kay, is that things are rarely what they seem.
It's simple, Jedi. I've loved Princess Galia for years, and she's loved me.
But what I don't understand is how you two from two warring peoples came to meet in the first place.
The Beast Riders have been going in and out of the city for years, trading secretly with the political underground.
Yes, we've been plotting the overthrow of the government.
We came here to prevent a war, Beast Lord.
I'm ready to talk peace, but I'm also ready to make war.
Aye, aye!
But either way, Jedi, Auron and I were going to marry.
It was unthinkable that the royal daughter of Onderon would marry a Beast Rider.
That's why we arranged my abduction. It was all a masquerade.
But the Beast Riders killed your soldiers during that so-called masquerade.
Cruel men. Evil men. They deserved to die.
No one deserves...
Ulic, I love my city. I love my mother and my dying father. But I can no longer live under the pall of the dark side of the Force.
The dark side? How can the dark side be on Onderon? You've had so little contact with other star systems.
4 centuries ago, a Jedi Knight named Freedon Nadd brought the dark power of the Sith to our world.
The Sith?
Yes, Ulic. The Sith studied the dark side. They were an ancient line of dark lords, but they're now extinct.
Extinct on your world, maybe, but in the city of Aziz, they are remembered. This Freedon Nadd died centuries ago, but his memory is worshipped by Queen Amanoa and King Omen.
This is moving too quickly for me. The dark side has ruled Aziz for 4 centuries?
You know that my people exile our lawbreakers and send them into the wilderness.
What you don't know is that these lawbreakers broke only one law. They defied the dark side. We were branded as criminals and banished. Everyone in this room has felt the dark power. And still we defy it.
Hear, hear!
Down with the dark side!
A Jedi? A dark Jedi caused all of this?
But the end is near. The armies of all the Beast Lords are gathering for a great and final battle against that cursed city. Jedi, will you help us throw down the power brought by one of your own? That has corrupted our world.
You want us to join a war?
Ulic, be careful.
Auron Kira, I promised my master that I would make war a last resort. Let's go to your mother and reveal your marriage. I'll make her see that your wedding should mark the end of this long war. Maybe she'll...
You don't know my mother, Jedi. And I fear that you don't know anything about the dark side.
Galia is right. You have no grasp of what's going on here. I will never let Galia set foot in Aziz again.
Trust me, please. I am a Jedi. The Jedi have to deal with the dark side all the time. Both of you will accompany me. Together we can bring peace to this chaotic world.
Galia?
Auron, my love. The Jedi may be our only hope.
Very well. We will trust you, Ulic Kheldroma. But tell me... When your plan fails, will you help us make war against the dark side?
If I fail, there won't be any other choice.
Can't that ship of yours fly any faster, Ulic? My Beast Riders and I are tickling your belly and we hardly worked up a sweat.
Haha! Don't tempt me, Auron Kira. I'll leave you tasting ion afterburn for weeks.
Can't you fly a little lighter, Ulic? I just put the Ranger back together.
Sorry, Kay, but we've got to get back to Aziz before time runs out. Auron Kira may have agreed to follow us on his winged beast,
but he left word for his army to prepare for war.
Well, the city's just ahead on our scopes. I'm sure they'll be happy to see us again.
Or not. They're firing on us.
Is this security? This is the Nebulan Ranger. Cease fire! Cease fire!
Shields holding.
Nebulan Ranger, you are flying in the company of our mortal enemies. Heave to, or we'll blast you from the sky.
Wait! We're bringing in the Queen's daughter! In the name of the Jedi, we call for a peace conference between Queen Amanoa and the Beast Riders.
Our guns have a lock, sir. Your orders?
Allow them to land. Initiate security protocols and alert the Queen.
Do you think Her Majesty will agree to a peace treaty with the Beast Riders?
Never!
But Your Majesty, if you truly want peace...
You are a fool, Ulic Keldroma. As all the Jedi are fools. And you, Galia, my only daughter, how dare you betray us? Never will you belong to an outcast. I will see you die first.
Queen Amanoa, I represent the Jedi and the Galactic Republic. If Onderon wants to leave its dark ages and join the community of worlds, then you must put aside these hatreds.
Mother, listen to him, please. My marriage to Orin can make the beginning to a new age, an end to this evil worship, and the beginning of an age of light.
And if you will not listen, Your Majesty, I, Auron Kira, swear that the skies will grow dark with the beating of our war beasts.
You want darkness, Auron Kira? I'll show you darkness!
Mother, what are you doing?
Ulic, do you sense it?
Yes, a power. The dark side is rising.
I call upon the spirit of Frida Nad, a Jedi far greater than these impotent youths. May his dark power fill me now!
The dark side! It's everywhere! Stifling the Force!
Guards! Surround them!
We hear Queen Amanoa.
Ulic, those guards! Dozens of them!
Don't worry, Kay. 3 Jedi are worth 100 men with blasters.
Foolish Jedi. These are Dark Side adepts, worshippers of the Dark Lord Frida Nad. More than a match for little boys. Guards, by the power of the Dark Side, I command you, destroy them!
Hey, you men! Get that war beast settled!
Yes, sir.
You there, lock down that turbo laser. You want it to blow you out of the saddle?
Sorry, sir.
Hey, Gobi, take it easy. Just because Auron Kira left you in charge of his army doesn't mean you have to polish every buckle.
I can't take it easy. Not while Auron's stuck inside that rock pile. Wait a minute. That's my comlink. This is Gobi.
Gobi, this is Auron Kira. We're under attack. The Jedi mission has failed, and we're under fire. Launch your counter-strike.
But what about you? Where can we find you?
We're safe for the moment. We've taken cover, but we're caught in a crossfire. If you don't launch your attack soon, we'll all be...
Auron!
I'm all right. A blaster shot singed the hair off my arm.
Singed the... Auron, you're bleeding.
There's no time to worry about that. Well, Jedi, you've gotten us into this mess. Can you get us out?
I can. Across this chamber is a door that leads down an unused corridor.
But the minute we move, those royal guards will cut us to pieces.
No, they won't. I'll cover your retreat.
Kay, you're my brother. I can't ask you to...
Did you think you were the only one with courage, Ulic? Now go! And leave these Darksiders to me!
Kay!
This way! The door is locked!
Now it's open. Let's go! Ow! What is this, a junk room? It's full of broken down droids and spare parts.
This is my father's old laboratory. It is seldom used now.
We have no time for talk. We must leave immediately.
Tot, take Galia and Auron Kira back to the Nebulan Ranger and secure it.
What about you?
Kay is still back there. I'm going after him.
Get him.
He fights like a demon.
Destroy the Jedi.
One Jedi is enough to defeat you!
Your Majesty,
Navar, where did you come from?
Scanners report thousands of beast riders approaching the city, the largest army we've ever seen.
Very well, Navar. Order the defense towers to fire ion cannons and turbo lasers at will.
Shall we take you to safety?
No. I am going to prepare a more powerful weapon.
Gunner 4 to Gunner 1, relay sensor data.
Gunner 1 to Gunner 4, I'm tracking a squad of war beasts. They should be coming into your range.
I copy, Gunner 1. Turbo lasers charged and ready. But you'd better be careful. You got beast riders approaching from your rear. Watch your back! Ah!
Gunner 4! Gunner 4, can you hear me? Repeat message. I couldn't hear the end of your...
He was trying to tell you to watch your back.
Ah!
This is Commander Gobi to all squadron commanders. We've secured every tower on the northern wall. All wings, commence your attack run!
It doesn't matter. How many soldiers you send against me, you won't stop me from finding the Queen.
By the ghost of Frida Nad, he's just one man. Can't you defeat one man?
Navar, security reports that the Beast Riders have overrun the northern wall. They're inside the city walls.
No matter. They are fools. They cannot realize that we possess the ultimate weapon. I'm more concerned with this Jedi nuisance. I shall have to take care of this myself. Give me your blaster.
Here.
Go. Tell our forces to continue fighting until the Queen has prepared her counterattack. Now, to wait for just the right moment.
Ugh! That's... last! Kay! Ulic! How nice of you to show up, just as I have things under control.
Two Jedi in my sights. Which shall it be?
Where is Tot?
Him, I think.
He's taking Galia and Orin back to our ship. Where's the Queen?
Escaped, I... Kay! Your arm! My arm! They've cut off my arm!
I've got a squad of city dwellers holed up in that bunker!
Watch that sniper!
Holding them back at the first gate!
Weapons depot, control your fire!
Destroy the city dwellers!
Down with Isis! Down with Frida Nad!
Forward! Forward!
Commander Gobi, we're still taking heavy fire from the royal palace.
I don't care. That's where Orin Kira's last transmission originated. I want him out of there.
But what about those turbo lasers?
I'll take care of those. Just get going.
Yes, sir.
This is Commander Gully to Flight Leader Kurt.
Kurt here. Yes, Commander?
Pull your beast riders off the eastern wall and swing them around to the palace. Oh, that was close. Somebody lay some suppressing fire along that rooftop. I've got ground troops taking heavy fire up there.
Affirmative. We're on our way.
Gobi. And somebody get that sniper off that roof.
Gobi.
Orin. Orin, by the four moons, you're alive!
Alive and fighting, Gobi.
Where's your new bride?
She's safe with the alien Jedi, Tot Danita. I came to help with the battle.
Well, you may be too late, Orin. We've taken half a city. I've got ground troops in the streets and six wings of beast riders making strafing runs over the city. The only thing I was worried about was trying to find you! Orin, the reign of the dark side is over!
Don't be too rash, Gobi. We can't defeat the dark side without those Jedi. And right now, I don't even know if they're dead or...
Alive, Kay. You look so pale. You've lost a lot of blood. And your arm.
Don't be... Oh, stupid, Ulik. I can live without my arm.
I've got a medikit here. This may hurt.
Oh! Good thing I can handle a lightsaber with my other hand. Where are we?
I didn't think you'd want to wait around for more of Queen Aminoa's dark side warriors. Here, bite down on this while I stop the blood flow.
Ugh! Ow!
Princess Golia showed me this room. It's some sort of old laboratory that used to belong to King Omen.
Laboratory? Looks more like a cybernetic shop. Bionic limbs, cannibalized droid parts. I'd say old King Omen dabbled in bioreconstruction.
That's very interesting, but I'm a little too worried about your arm to care.
Well, if that thing in the corner is what I think it is, I'm getting myself a better fighting arm!
What are you doing? There's a war going on outside, and I'm trying to keep you from bleeding to death. This is no time to start fixing antique droids.
This is an old XT6 model, Ulik. Their appendages make great prosthetics. Are the others safe?
Tatanita is taking Golia to the Nebulan Ranger. Oren Kira has joined the battle.
What about the Queen?
I don't know where she is, and it worries me.
Here, I've reached the tomb. Those cursed Jedi will never find me here. Buried in the depths of the palace, with the tomb of Freedon Nat. Freedon Nat. For years I worshipped your name. For a lifetime I served the memory of your dark power. Now, in the name of my husband, King Omen, in the name of his ancestor, Freedon Nad, I call down the power of the dark side upon these foes!
Oren Kira, we have a prisoner!
Excellent, Gobi. Bring him up here. I'm using this captured sensor tower as a headquarters. Computer?
Computer on.
Activate sensor array. Scan this sector for all inbound starships. I want to know about any battleships the Queen may have waiting to attack.
Working.
Here's our prize, Oren! A member of the Queen's entourage! On your knees, Darksider!
No Onderonian ships located.
What is your name, city dweller?
I am called Navarre, and it is you who should be on your knees, Beast Rider.
Warning, one off-world ship detected. Planet of origin, Arcania.
Me on my knees? Why? When I have control of the city?
You can have the city. We have the power of the dark side.
What is that?
Some kind of darkness settling over the city.
Gobi, what?
Pain! 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 Can't stand it!
Computer, identify disturbance.
Wave force, energy type unknown. Anomalous power surges detected. Corollary information. Approaching off-world ship unaffected by power surge.
Princess Golia, this way. The Nebulon Ranger is just ahead.
I see it, Tatanita.
Once we reach the ship, we'll...
Tot! What's the matter?
Momentary pain. It's gone now. I'm all right, Princess.
What was it?
I don't know. A dark shadow has fallen. It caught me off guard. Everything's all right now.
No, it's not. Look!
The Beast Rider's army. They've gone mad.
By the four moons, it's begun affecting everyone.
Oh, my eyes! My eyes!
Get it off me! Get it off me!
Whatever this force is, it's some kind of madness infecting all my troops.
It is the magic of the Sith, Oren Kira. A power you cannot fight.
Your queen's petty magic cannot...
Cannot what, Beast Rider? Cannot harm you?
The battle is lost. Lost. Your strength is gone. Your will is gone. Your life...
voices in my head.
The voices speak the truth, Beast Rider. The battle is lost. Your people are doomed.
Lost! Doomed!
Come outside with me, Onderon Kira, and watch your people die.
Proximity alert. Off-world starship has reached city limits.
View screen on. Give me a visual on the battle. By all the Jedi.
Fall back! Fall back!
Our beasts have gone mad! They're out of control!
The city dwellers are on the attack! We're being ground up like gravel maggots! Look out!
Block 3 to Block 6. We've retaken the northern wall.
Affirmative, Block 3. That'll teach those beast riders to defy the dark side. We've got an armored company moving in to support you.
We surrender. We surrender. Just stop the pain.
You should know by now, Beast Rider. The followers of Frieda Nad have no mercy.
Do you see, Onderon Kira?
Lost. We've lost.
We have the dark side power of Frieda Nad on our side. Your beast riders mean nothing. And now it's time
for you to feel the edge of my knife.
By the Force, I could not let that happen. I had trained my three Jedi to prevent this violence. So many deaths, so much hatred. It was time I intervened.
Voices paralyzing.
This is the last battle for you, Onderon Kira. The power is with the city.
Every soldier knows that war is more than arms and armor. Every warrior carries an image of impending victory in his heart.
Don't move now. One quick stroke of my knife, and all your worries will be ended.
When the image shatters, to be replaced by defeat, he is beaten.
Lost. The battle is...
But sometimes, a warrior receives assistance from an unexpected source, an inrush of light blasting away his fear and despair.
Now, Onderon Kira.
Releasing new inner strength.
You die.
No!
What? You still resist?
Yes. A war is much more than arms and armor.
Yes! To the last!
Half of every conflict is the will to win. We are Jedi. We must recognize that the will to win and the power of war are given sometimes by the dark side.
No!
And sometimes, as dawn throws back the night, victory is given by the light.
Never, Ulic, should you underestimate the power of the Force to inspire others.
So it was you, Master Arca. You used the Force to influence the battle.
Yes.
I felt it. I, Onderon Kira, felt a knife at my throat. I could not move. And then, suddenly, strength flowed through me. I thought it was my own courage.
It was, Onderon Kira. I merely used the Force to awaken what was already in you.
Master Arca, I watched the battle.
1 minute, the Beast Riders were defeated. The next minute, they were unstoppable.
And you, Kay, my son, your arm is gone. Have you already begun to throw your flesh away in your hunger for the greater light?
My arm, gone. Yes, Master. But I... I've got another. This droid arm will serve me well once I've adapted it.
Kay's wound is my fault, Master Arca.
Ulic, I made you my charge, man, and you have utterly failed the test I gave you.
But Master Arca, we did everything we could.
So you did. But the dark side is at work here. You should have sensed it the moment you arrived.
I guess I was too eager.
As for this great war you have launched, the way to win it was the way I won it. I used the Jedi technique of battle meditation, influencing the battle's outcome.
I'm sorry.
You rely too much on your strong arms and brave spirit. Do not forget the Force. By visualizing the desired results of a battle, a Jedi influences the field of Force that surrounds all events. Now, come with me. We still must find Queen Amanoa and the source of all this trouble.
Redonat, protect me. The dark side will come to me. Frida Nad, protect me. The dark side will come to me.
Are you sure you know where you're taking us, Golia?
I can't be sure. These catacombs under the city extend for miles. Many people have wandered down here and been lost forever.
Why would anyone come down here in the first place?
Treasure seekers? Worshippers of the dark side?
They say the tomb of the Dark Jedi, Freedon Nad, is hidden down here. But that's just a myth.
Like most myths, it leads to the truth. Behold.
No! Mother!
Queen Amanoa, why is she kneeling before that stone coffin?
Master Arca, is that...
Yes, Ulic. The tomb of the Dark Side Master, Freedon Nad.
Defilers! You do not belong here!
I feel the dark side here. It's so powerful.
Dark forces linger around this old sarcophagus, Ulic, but my light is stronger.
No! No! The light! The light! Yeah!
Mother! Master Arca, you killed her!
Golia.
I don't care how evil she was. She was my mother. I loved her.
I did not kill her. The dark power that supported her has fled. Let us have a look at the remains of Freedon Nad.
But that stone coffin is far too heavy to lift.
Size means nothing to the Force, Ulic. Behold, the Dark Jedi.
Even after 4 centuries, those brittle bones, that Death's Head grin.
He looks so evil.
Freedon Nad was seduced by the dark side. He apprenticed himself to a dark lord of the Sith. After his death, his tomb became a focus of dark side energy, and so his power passed from generation to generation. All your ancestors belong to the dark side, Golia. But that is over. The shadow has been broken. You are free.
Hey, Kay! Come on, brother! Princess Golia and Orin Kira are about to be crowned king and queen of Iziz. You want to miss the fun?
Be right there, Ulic. I've almost got this new arm working.
Ulic?
Master Arca, what is it?
Don't be too quick to celebrate. Our battle with the dark side is far from over.
But the queen, the sarcophagus, I thought we won.
The battle, yes, but the war goes on. Freedon Nad still has a great following in this city. His cult may still cause trouble. There are even rumors that Princess Galia's father, King Omen, is still alive somewhere on the planet.
King Omen?
I'll need you and your brother Kay and Tot Danita to stay on here for a while.
Well, I'm ready.
Kay, that mechanical arm actually suits you.
Anyone for arm wrestling?
Well done, Kay. We'll need your arm and your spirit in the weeks ahead, but I'm afraid we'll need even more.
What do you mean?
I'm thinking of calling on other Jedi for help. Master Thon is the watchman for the Stennis system. He may be able to send someone to help us with this dark side threat.
Master Arca, Freedon Nadd was a Jedi. How can a Jedi trained in the ways of the light fall victim to the dark side?
It has happened more than once. Fortunately, it does not happen often. Ulic, my son, pray that it never happens to you.